So my name is Saurabh. I'm from Red Hat. I'm working at Red Hat from almost more than 1.5 years now. So I was an intern at Red Hat, and I got converted in Red Hat before 6 months now. So yeah. So today I will be covering about how we can grow Fedora Silverblue community and locally or to globally or the corners. So this is not the thing that I'm giving some mantras to you that we can do this and we can grow the community, but I can share some things that I have faced in my college days, in my engineering time, that we can improve those things and we can go ahead with those things. Okay. So I'll share my story with you first, that how I get to know about Fedora and Fedora community. So okay. So when I was in my second year, not many people know about open source community. So one of my senior was working for open source community, and he was engaged in open source community. So from there, I got to know about open source community. So from that time, I went ahead. I liked the open source I liked the open source thing. So open source was, I got attracted to open source at that time because open source was like, collaboration was there. So collaboration is the thing that got me attracted to open source, because so many people are coming together, they are planning, they are giving their information, they are sharing their information at that time. So I went ahead, I went to open source community, I went, then somehow I get to know about Fedora community. Then in my third year, I started going for test days, Fedora test days, and I contributed to Fedora 26 by raising a bug over there. So someone passed that bug, and so many comments are going on that bug. So I got very inspired from them that if I'm doing something, someone is recognizing my work. So I got inspired, and then I started working with it. And then fortunately, I get into Mozilla as well. So I got I was a Mozilla campus ambassador at my college. Then from that, I saw people. The students were struggling to get into this community or to get into open source community, because they knew that we need to go and we need to do something that people are not doing. We need to do something that is out of box, but they are lagging out of lagging out of the path that how we can do that. So the human mentality is that we need someone to be our leader. We need someone to lead us to the path where we wanted to go. We are very lazy to do something on our own. So what I thought, I went ahead, I created a club in college. I went to principal, I asked him that, can I create a club in college? He was absolutely fine. So I created a club there called Coding Club, where I was used to take classes on Saturday, Sunday in colleges regarding open source communities. Regarding GitHub, regarding Fedora, what is Red Hat, how is Red Hat, how is Fedora, what are all other communities which student can go and contribute. So yeah, that time it worked very well. I got so many participation from students and the teachers as well. So people were were attracted to this thing. So then I thought, okay, cool, it's going very good. People are contributing to these things. People are interested to do this, because what happens nowadays, institutions, organizations are looking for the opportunities for their students to make them look out of box, because every institution has doing the same thing right now, following the same academic rules, following the lectures, following all our things. So they are looking for the things that make their student look out of box. So what we can do here in colleges, so we have Fedora Campus Ambassador thing, but when I was in my third year, I tried for it, but I failed, because for a Fedora Campus Ambassador, you need to have some good experience with it. The thing, good experience, you need to have more than 1 year experience in Fedora community, I think, because I had faced this issue when applying to this Fedora Campus Ambassador. I got rejected because of this thing, that you are not that experienced, you don't have that much of knowledge of Fedora. So I think what we can do, we can create a local club at colleges, like Fedora Silverblue Club, where students can come and where students can contribute to Fedora Silverblue, where students can get to know about Fedora Silverblue there. So creating that club will give you an opportunity to get into touch with students, how they feel about Fedora Silverblue, because as we are calling Fedora Silverblue as a next generation Fedora workstation, so I think we should treat it as a separate entity, or we should show it as a separate entity to people that this is thing we are working on and we want to make this thing happen. So yeah, so I was an organizer at DevConf before, I guess, 1 week. So I made brand profit there. So we were talking about that what we can do to leverage this community. So I came to know that only 25% of Red Hatters are contributing to Fedora, not more than 25% of Red Hatters. So I thought we can start it from Red Hat as well. So what we can do, we can also create a club in Red Hat. So I went ahead. I met my colleagues in Red Hat. I met some of people from Red Hat who are interested in contributing to Red Hat, contributing to Fedora. So they were like, we are ready to contribute to Fedora because it will make them look out of the box. Like, it will give them opportunities to make new connections also. So they are like, but we don't know how we can do it. Like, they know Fedora, okay, they use Fedora, but they don't know how to contribute to Fedora or Fedora Silverblue, because they don't have any path to do that. Even if we have all the videos, even if we have all the contents, all the things available on the internet so that they can come and they can see and they can contribute. But we need a leader there. We need something that people can come and people can listen to and people can go and ahead and do the things. So I think we can start from our own offices. So so we should have like local offices from a local Red Hat. If we are targeting India or any region, so we should have a single office, single club or single group in one single office. So we can have so many people there, so people can come here and we can share the knowledge of Fedora Silverblue. So best practices, I think it includes creating a local club in colleges or so right now, Fedora Silverblue, if you can see, Twitter handle of Fedora Silverblue, it is going very good. People are like liking it, and we are continuously updating the Silverblue page on Twitter. But if you think of social marketing and Facebook, we are not that active for Silverblue thing. Or if you go for Instagram, we are not that active. So I think there are some areas which we should work so that people could know about this Fedora Silverblue, that what is Fedora Silverblue, because if I go to ask someone that what is Fedora Silverblue, they are like, it's a software, that's it. And someone is like, I don't know what is Fedora Silverblue, so they need to Google it and they'll get to know. So I think we should have some social networking in. Yeah. So this is more of discussion because this is my starting phase in Fedora Silverblue community where I can grow this community, and what steps should I take in my region to grow it in the all over the corners or from my local region to all the world. So I'm here to discuss you with these guys that what are your plans or what are your opinions about it, that what should we do or what should we not do to this. So Matthew.
Yeah. So I find the idea of student clubs interesting, but it's been a long time since I was in college, and also a long time since I even worked at a college, a university. Are student clubs, at least in your part of the world, student clubs are kind of a big part of the student life, and how, if we don't have somebody, you started a club because you were there, don't have somebody on the ground already, how do we go reach out to the university and say we want to start this club? How do we attract that first starter person?
So I told you earlier that universities and organizations are looking for the things which make the student look out of box, because If you're planning to, so what is the goal of the student learning in engineering college? They wanted to place in good companies, right? So to be placed in good companies, they need to have something more or extra than academics things. So this thing, contributing to open source, contributing to Fedora, will make them look make out of box so that people can, so companies can take a look out of them that this guy is doing something different than the regular academic things. So yeah. So I had the same doubt as you had. So I went to some college at my region. I asked them that this is my plan. Like I'm so in mostly India, in mostly colleges in India, the principal, the institutions are looking for the people for the guest lectures which can come to our college and give some lectures on other things, other technologies, what going on, because no one from college students want to attend a lecture from his teacher in the college, because we are doing that the same, the daily. So yeah, so if we can go and if we can talk to universities and colleges, they are very welcoming. Like I have seen this. So yeah, because so many institutions are also the Red Hat Academy. So using Red Hat Academy, we can target the institutions from there, because so many people from different colleges are in Red Hat Academy, or there are some institutions which provides Red Hat certifications also. So every people are looking forward to have, yeah. Okay.
One of the things I always had a challenge with was coming up, I always felt like it was more difficult and more worthwhile to have like interactive, engaging things to get people hands-on with these things. And I'm coming at this from a different perspective of our community has been around for over 10 years. We have like a little bit more of an established base. Mm-hmm. So we're probably at a different point than trying to start from the bottom. But I think, do you think it would be more helpful to have like informational resources that would help you explain or like introduce these topics to people, or like what kind of, or any interactive resources would be more useful? And if so, like what do you think those might look like for people who you are in your community?
Yeah, you like told well that we have the base created before, and we have some meetups over there in each and every city. If I remember, each and every city we have some meetups called open source meetups, so where people come and people try to get some any information that they want. So what we can do, we can using social networking. So the people who are attracted to open source, the people who wanted to be wanted to contribute to open source are really liking this Facebook Fedora page. We can post it there that we are having these things or. So it depends. Like if it depends in the cities, I guess, because at some of the cities, some of the region, there are active communities already as well. So what we can do, we can reach out to them, or if there is not active community, we can go and build one from the college. So what if you build one community in a new community in the college? So that what will happen? It is a long process. It won't do it in like 1 month, 2 months, because it needs time, right? Because if you gonna create a community, so it would take time to have. If we are creating community in college, so if people are in fourth year, so they know the community because they have created it and they know it. But people from first year, they won't know it because they are new to community. So it will take some time to regulate those community in college. So yeah.
Yeah. Universities to start those initiatives. So like maybe one way you could think of it is there's like already existing folks from Red Hat in India that go to the different universities with their workshops. So maybe that could be like one approach for trying to do like new communities from the ground up, but for like you personally are trying to like reach places where there are like more specific targeted areas where it'd be a lot harder to start from the ground up. You could try to tap into these existing meetups or groups and try to like get in the loop on what's going on with those communities and use that. It might be like an easier inroad for you or for others to make a have less resistance to getting into there and like bringing some content to people and getting feedback.
Yeah, right. I thought the same at the first time, but if you think if we are going to ask people about being in in this community if for a meetup thing, like, so it will only have, or if the Red Hatter is going to some college and giving talks about Fedora Silverblue or telling people that we have this, so it will be only limited to that session only. So what if the speaker goes out and after a week, what will happen? Because people is not that communicated with the college, so there is no thing that we have, there is no communication medium between us and college that time. So to fix that medium, I'm thinking to build a group in college locally so that we can contact to that leader which is in college, which is talking about Fedora Silverblue. So we can contact the leader, and so leader can contact us, and that would go. Because if the guest lecture or the meetup we are talking about, it will only be limited to that span of time. Student leader, because, yeah.
Sorry, I guess my question still is, how do we find those student leaders and identify them and empower them?
We can run a campaign. So there are different, like Mozilla do. So, Hacker Earth do. I was a Hacker Earth campus ambassador as well. So we should, we can run a campaign in Fedora. Like we are giving this perks to students which are going to be a community leader here, because it will also give some feather on their top that students is doing something good, something different than this. We only just have to show people that the whoever person is handling this thing is like have some good communication thing, is very good at public speaking, he has some good knowledge of technicality, so we can do that. So using Fedora site, social networking, we should start from there, because that is...
We do have some community funding, we have money, we can
There's
a good use for it, and it sounds like maybe some sort of campaign around that we'd be willing to spend on it, I guess, if it helps.
Yeah, so being from a continentally sized country myself as well, I have a perception much easier to create online communities than physical communities. And one thing we could at least start considering is having localized docs. I see that we recently migrated to GitHub, but there's no story of nobody going forward into internationalization or like translating the docs. I've been asked by non-local groups in Brazil about information about Silverblue, and they are still very limited about the language barrier.
Cool.
So it would be very nice to do something very simple to do because it's online, right? So I guess online communities could be a great start.
Yeah, and also translation itself is a way that can help build the community. Say it can be a core activity. We have this good documentation, but it's only in English. Please help us make this documentation available
right.
to your country.
I was telling about the local federal group, right? So using that silver group, what we can do, we can create some hackathons over there also. We can have some hackathons there. We can have some guest lectures from Red Hatters. We can have some guest lectures from students also. The students who are working at this, learning at the same college, so they can do the same thing, I guess. Yeah, but that is a good point. Online communities. Obviously, they are just. We are not touched with anyone offline in that community. So people. I have seen people not doing their work regularly in online community because they don't have that liability, they don't have responsibility to do this. And if you're facing someone offline, I think that would be a like more good thing that people would go ahead and contribute to things, because they know if I go face this person at personally, so he will ask me that, what did you do? So what should I tell? Because I didn't do anything.
Sometimes that acknowledgement of the local community is also push them to do more work. There's some groups that I've been recently added, and they are unofficial, and people don't feel like pushing projects forward because they are not acknowledged by the main community. So endorsing local communities and giving them some sort of credibility means that is also might push people to to feel like represented. Yeah.
So that's that's some work basically of developing a process to become an official community and some guidelines for if you're official community, you know, you accept the Fedora Code of Conduct, you are structured this way, you meet this often, and you give reports, and that's what makes you official, because we don't want to just say, you know, oh yeah, anybody who wants to be official, and then we have too much, then we have a mess.
Right.
But having that process, and we don't have a process like that, so developing is probably some work to do. I like to generate work, that's my job.
That's the thing. If anyone has anything on it.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, guys.